boy. No.
No. Is it really a haul if the booktuber didn't drop shit while they were trying to make a thumbnail? We don't go the same places
that we used to go. Hello, how are you? I hope you're good.
My last haul was actually 7 months ago, so it's been a while since we added new books to G's library, because usually I get quite rambly on each book. So I actually made a list here so I don't keep you here for forever. And I wrote down just a little bit of why I got the book, what's it about briefly, and what the rating is on Goodreads, because I thought it would be fun to just kind of know. And that being said, let's get on with it. I will. I got lazy there for a second, but I will put the links in the description bar for all of these books if you want to check them out. As well as I will also mention a couple of people who were the reason why I got the book, because I heard them talk about it or they personally recommended it to me, and I will link their channels down below as well. First up, we have Triangulum, which just arrived in the post. So Triangulum is a South African-inspired adult sci-fi. As far as I know, it's adult from what I've seen on Goodreads, but it does say that the narrator is a seemingly adrift 17-year-old. But it says the narrator. So I don't know, it might be a trick. It says that the South African National Space Agency receives a mysterious package containing a memoir and a set of digital recordings from this woman that claims that the world is actually going to end. From the bat, I was very intrigued and really looking forward to reading this. This one does have a 3.62 rating out of 175, so there's not a very well-known book. I cannot remember where I've seen it. I can't remember who recommended it, so I'm sorry about that. Speaking of sci-fi, I also picked up Ascender Volume 2. Ascender is a continuation of Descender, which is a comic series of 6 volumes. I have already finished that, but I have not continued with Ascender, but Logan has, so we knew it's one of those few series that I actually continue to collect. So I just needed to buy it. Then I have Kingdom of Souls, which is actually a read, rate, review book for August, so I will be reading this month for sure. And Kingdom of Souls is about a girl who was born into the family of witch doctors. However, she really struggles to get her powers, and the ancestral powers just don't seem to come to her. So she is going about trying all the different ways and desperate ways of getting her powers to kick in, and whilst doing that, she stumbles upon a bigger plot of awakening this demon king. This has almost 2,500 ratings, and currently it's standing at 3.79. Then I have a historical adult fiction, if you would believe. It's called This Lovely City. This book is set in 1950 London, and it's all about this jazz musician who immigrates from Jamaica to London and stumbles upon this mysterious event. And after a little while, he becomes almost a main suspect in the case, and we are solving it, as far as I know. Ooh, look at those end papers. I actually haven't seen how it is like it. I'm hoping this is going to be super intriguing. I'm not a big reader of historical fiction, but it seemed like a good mixture of a lot of things in this book, so I'm hoping that this is just going to fix my opinion of historical fiction, because the miniature is forever ruined it for me. Well, maybe not forever, but for the time being. This book currently have over 700 ratings, so not a lot, and is sitting at 3.94 rating, which is not bad. Then we have Blackbird. You're right. We have Blackbird, which is a really beautiful comic. I am so excited to read it. I've needed a new comic in my life so badly. It's a comic about a girl who discovers this hidden magical world within LA, but also needs to save her sister. I've seen Jade talk about this one, and then I've seen her flick through the beautiful art. And I mean, come on, like, this is such a vibe that I approve of. Extremely excited about this. Probably will get to it fairly soon. It's a fairly thick one as well, which is good because comics are not the cheapest. I'm very, very excited. And currently this one has around 2,500 ratings, and it's sitting at 3.66, so quite medium. So I'd like to kind of like adjust my expectations accordingly, but I am very excited because I really need to find a new comic that I'm super excited about, because other than Descender, I've been kind of stuck on that front. Now, the next one I feel like a lot of people have seen everywhere, and that is Mexican Gothic, which is an adult gothic horror. And historical fiction, it was also labeled under historical fiction, so who am I? I don't know. Our main character, Naomi, or Nomi, I'm not sure, receives a letter from her newlywed cousin that something fishy is happening and that she would hope that, you know, Nomi comes to help. So she moves into this ancient manor that's called High Place. And once she's in the High Place, she starts dreaming these very gory, threatening dreams that seem to come from the house and the manor itself. And there's also a lot of dodgy people living in there, something like that. I have continuously now from many sources heard that the first half is much better than the second, so I'm a bit sad about that, but I'm trying to keep an open mind, and I'm very excited for the gothic feels of this book. I have not read a lot of gothic reads, nor have I read a lot of horror, so honestly, I should be easy to scare because of that, I think. I'm just very excited to see, ooh, look how pretty. Very excited to delve into that. And it does have over 16,000 of ratings, and it's currently sitting at 3.84, so pretty standard. Yeah, at the very back, it's saying, he's trying to poison me, you must come for me, Nomi. You have to save me, so she's saving her cousin. Very excited, and also extremely hoping that I like this author's writing style, because I've ordered another book without realizing it's the same author, and now I'm just really hoping that I didn't made an oopsie. But the book is Gods of Jade and Shadow. This one is not a horror, however it is historical fiction again, but also mythology. It's an adult book. So we're trying that, and this one really piqued my interest because it's all about making deals with Mayan gods, and that in itself was enough for me to grab onto this. It doesn't hurt that it has a beautiful cover, just saying. It is also inspired by Mexican folklore, which I wonder how I didn't add one of them, but I didn't, and now I have two books of the same author. Fingers crossed that I like the writing style. Has over 18,000 ratings, and the rating is 3.9, which is pretty good. It's fairly hard to go over 4 stars on Goodreads if you have a reasonable amount of ratings. The next one is actually a beautifully foolish endeavor, and I am not one for buying books that are second in the series that I haven't started, but like a lot of my favorite things have this big metal statue trope, a mysterious robot kind of thing. We have that in Sleeping Giants, we have that in Descender, and I just love it. So I have a feeling that I love this one too, and they stopped printing hardcovers here in UK, so I wanted to just get it to match. The first one is basically, it was blue underneath, a story of these mysterious statues appearing in the towns and no one really knowing what they are, what they do, and we follow the person that first uploads a video of them, so it's also about social media and stuff like that. Really, really want to get to that soon, and now that I have a second one, I also really hope that that will push me a bit more towards that. I didn't realize it's quite a chunker, but it is. And this one has over 6,000 ratings, and the rating is 4.47, which is amazing, but also worth noting that people who have read it most likely have liked the first one to begin with, so you have to count that, like take that into consideration when thinking about higher, lower ratings, because those who didn't like the first one will obviously not read the second one, so therefore the rating will automatically be higher. Anyway, next up we have The Last Confession of Autumn Casterly. This is a YA mystery thriller, and it's all about these sisters and their connection and getting to know each other, and one sister actually kind of disappears after a drug deal gone wrong, and this book promises themes of body positivity, although I am more on a body neutrality side of things, and also consent and sisterhood. And the sisterhood one is especially where I'm leaning for, but also like mystery, because you have to, or like a thriller part, because you have to find the sister within, you know, like a certain amount of time. I'm hoping it's going to be an exciting read. I don't think this one has a lot of ratings. No, it doesn't. It has 489 at the time that I was writing this, but the rating is 4.12, so that's promising. But we'll see about that. So the next one is actually recommended by you guys. When I asked you for thriller or mystery recommendations, this one by far was the most recommended one. And I actually have not read it, so I thought it was about time to, you know, go and fix that. And this is And Then There Were None by Agatha Christie, obviously an author, very well known. So there's basically 10 strangers that are invited into Soldier Island, and one by one they start dying off, basically aligning with the rhyme, the nursery rhyme, and we don't know who is the culprit, we don't know who's causing this, if anyone's gonna survive, and I assume it's about solving the mystery. It's quite a short one, which is, well, it's 250 pages, so it was actually quite a short one. It has overwhelming good rating for a book that has that many ratings, because this has... Oh, hello, Momo. Oh, you can't jump on that. No, no, no. Wait, I'll take you. So yeah, it has almost 800,000 ratings, and it's sitting at 4.26 stars. That's incredible. I'll report back. Consider my expectations raised. Then we have Full Disclosure, which is a YA contemporary. It is about a girl who is actually HIV positive and falls in love for the first time and has to navigate her with her condition in a not always understanding society. Also navigate fear, disclosure, and self-acceptance. This one has nearly 3,000 ratings, and the rating is actually 4.01 stars, which is amazing, so promising. Next one is, I think, a little bit lighter, and it's called Jackpot, which is a story about a girl who actually is very hardworking, and she has to work after school, and then after her work shift, she has to run and take care of her younger brother. So she doesn't really have any time to, you know, relax. One day she actually sells a winning lottery ticket, but that ticket is never claimed. So she wants to find the ticket and find the person that bought the ticket. But she cannot do that without the help of her classmate, who is actually very rich. And I think this book must explore the themes of when those two worlds that are very, very different clash. And I guess looking more into that. So this one has 2,500 reviews, and it's sitting at 4.08 stars, so a super good rating. We have a classic YA sci-fi, and I actually have watched the movie of this book ages ago, and I'm waited for, you know, a while so I forget what's it about and so I can read it, because I didn't know it was a book before I watched the movie, and now I'm at that point, so now I am hopefully gonna read this soon. And I'm talking about The Giver. Jonas lives safely within the community, a place where there is no war, no hunger, and no pain, but when he is selected as a receiver of memory, he starts to discover dark secrets that lie beneath the surface of his perfect world, secrets that will lead him to undertake an incredible journey. And this had an incredible amount of reviews. It actually had 1,745,000. And it's at 4.13. That is crazy. So I'm really excited to read this. And would this count as dystopia or utopia? I feel like it would count as a utopia. Or maybe dystopia. Utopia, right? And I don't know why I keep saying excited about that. Obviously, I'm excited about all of these. Why else would I have gotten them? Guess what else I'm excited about? Follow Me to Ground. Not only is the cover amazing, the premise sounds so intriguing. This is a book about a family of healers, but in order to heal, they actually open the bodies up and then temporarily bury them. And it's about a girl, I think she meets a guy and that she needs to heal, but something else happens. I don't quite know, but the first part was enough for me to be hooked in. I know Books and Lala spoke about this, and also Jesse from Both Eyes and Books. I'm just very excited to get into this. I can't wait. It sounds very chilling, and it sounds really intriguing. What a concept. And I've been watching Hannibal. I don't want to talk about the third season, because what in the hell? Why was it ruined? Why did someone ruin such a good series? But anyway, you will see in the second half of this haul that I definitely was influenced in my book buying decision by the fact that Hannibal had ended and I was not satisfied. But this is kind of part of it. This one has 7,500 reviews and is sitting at 3.66, so it's not the highest of ratings. So I'm trying not to be super excited because sometimes that hinders if I have too high of an expectation. But I mean, come on, it just sounds so good. Then I have a book that I actually have already read, and that is Get a Life, Chloe Brown. If you want my more like in-depth kind of thoughts, you can watch my latest vlog. I go into that a little bit there. But Get a Life, Chloe Brown follows a chronically ill character and another character who is basically a tortured artist trope. This book, no matter what I was expecting out of this book to begin with, this book will forever probably mean a lot to me because of the chronically ill part. So it was basically talking about all of my insecure, well, not all, but part of my insecurities, and something that really hit home when I was not necessarily looking for it. But yeah, I never actually read books to be seen. I never read to relate. That is not my primary reason for reading books, but this one just surprised me a bit, I guess. Another thing that really surprised me is that this is a very steamy romance. The cover made me think, I was going into this thinking that this was actually kind of like more YA. It is not. It is about 30-year-old people. So they were very steamy. Currently it has almost 29,000 ratings and it's sitting at 3.89. So this is where we start a little bit with the Hannibal side of things. So very much on brand with the Hannibal show, I went and purchased the Red Dragon, which is the book that the show was kind of based on, especially the third season, but I'm assuming the book is better, I'm hoping. As far as I could tell, this is where Hannibal's story even begins, even though Hannibal is already in the story, so I'm not quite sure. But it mentions the same cast, which was very exciting for me. I might be a bit confused though. If that's not the first thing in the series and I should read something else before that, please let me know. I'm just looking at the back. Usually it says that. No, I think that's the first one. But I never really realized that we're just thrown in there when. Anyway, it's also floppy, so you know, extra points. So this one has 267,000 ratings and it is sat on 4.03, so very decent. The next one is actually a non-fiction book, as a true crime. Comprehensive study of the killings and subsequent investigation explores the circumstances surrounding this terrible crime and the effect it had on those involved. This is controversial and compelling. In Cold Blood, reconstructs the 1959 murder of a Kansas farmer, his wife, and his children. So nice and cheery, little coffee table read. This one actually has 500,000 reviews and the rating is 4.07, so can't be that bad. I mean, it can, but we'll see. Okay, next thing we have, We Were Liars. I understand that some of these books, I'm super late to the game. I mean, there's no game. You can be as late as you want. On the back, all it says is, we are liars, we are beautiful and privileged, we are cracked and broken, a tale of love and romance, a tale of tragedy. Which are lies, which is truth? You decide. So all I've heard from this, and a lot of reviews say that this has an amazing twist at the end, and so I basically bought it for that. Because I'm clearly seeking some thrill and excitement here with this whole haul, and I mean, we're hoping for some of that here. It has over 400,000 ratings and the rating, the average is 3.84, which is all right, on a good side. Then I have a book that you probably have seen everywhere, and that is Felix Ever After. This is a YA contemporary, and it's a story about a black, queer, and transgender boy. He has to navigate, again, falling in love, finding himself, but also someone is actually blackmailing him and exposing him for his birth name and the photos pre-transition, which is an extremely traumatic thing to even happen. It's awful. So it's a story about that. I like that it says, but as he navigates his complicated feelings, Felix begins a journey of questioning and self-discovery that helps redefine his most important relationship, how he feels about himself. Which I always stand behind the message. It has close to 6,000 ratings and the average is 4.54, which is extremely high. Maybe the highest of all of the books, so interesting. And then I have a somewhat random book for me, I guess. It's called And Then There Were Crows. I really like the cover. It does things to me. I don't know. I just like the simplicity. This is an urban adult horror novel. It's about a woman who lives in Queens in New York, and she kind of goes around just kind of minding her own business and focusing on herself more so than anything else. But accidentally, she rents her flat to like a literal demon, and then has to work to recage all of the demonic powers that it releases, and has to ask for help for this person nearby, which I'm assuming romance or something like that. This is entirely Jesse's fault. I watched their haul, and the way they were talking about this just really got me excited, and I put it in the basket, and here we are. This one only has 49 reviews at the moment, and the rating was 3.39, so I'm not quite sure what to expect on this one, but I am intrigued, and I will get to it at some point. That I have been meaning to read for forever, but I haven't in the longest, and finally got my hands on it, and that is All Systems Red. It is an adult sci-fi, and at the back it says, in a corporate-dominated space-faring, future planetary missions must be approved and supplied by the company. Exploratory teams are accompanied by company-supplied security androids for their own safety, but in a society where contracts are awarded to the lowest bidder, safety isn't a primary concern. On a distant planet, a team of scientists are conducting surface tests, shadowed by their company-supplied droid of a self-aware sec unit that has hacked its own governor module and refers to itself, although never out loud, as Murderbot. Scornful of humans, all it really wants is to be left alone long enough to figure out who it is. But when a neighboring mission goes dark, it is up to the scientists and their Murderbot to get the truth. It has AI, and that's all I need. Again, I'm really, really big fan of sci-fi, and I'm really excited to read this and ashamed that I haven't read it yet. This book has 63,000 reviews, and the average is 4.15, which is super high, so high expectations accordingly. Then I have another adult horror fantasy. I don't know why, but apparently I'm gonna be scared for a while. I'm not into mermaids. It's just not been a concept that ever really pulled me. I'm okay without it. But this one is hot. Like, this one is scary, you know? This is supposed to be a scary mermaid tale. I'm talking about Into the Drowning Deep. Didn't realize it's such a chunker either. So there was a crew that set out to film a mockumentary of sorts and never came back. Now another crew sets out to see what happened and also, you know, presumably find the remains of the ship, or obviously meet the, I don't know if it's sirens or mermaids. This basically reminds me of Event Horizon. I feel like this is going to be a sea equivalent of Event Horizon. I don't know if you've seen it. I don't know if I would recommend. Into the Drowning Deep, heard really good things. I heard really good things, like a year ago. This has close to 13,000 reviews, and it stands at 4.02, which is a very good rating again. Here we go. We're gonna try that. On a much lighter note, much, much lighter note, I think, we have This Is What It Feels Like, another book that I have spotted on Jesse's haul. This is a sapphic YA novel and also deals a lot with drug recovery, which is a topic that I read a little bit as when I was growing up, actually, but I have not read anything recently off, so very excited about that. And someone also said that it is a perfect summer read, so I'm thinking it's probably still humorous, and it has a very sunny, appealing cover. I thought it was cool looking. It has 500 reviews and it's 4.05, although I do take the reviews with a grain of salt when the review number is lower, but it's still a very promising sign. Okay, we don't have many left now, I promise. The next one is recommended to me by Cody, and she was saying that this was a very punchy, like a very impactful little book, and it's a utopian setting, and it's called Pet. So our main character accidentally cuts herself around this painting of her that her mother has painted, and the painting starts coming alive. And this monster crawls out of the painting, as far as I understood. It was kind of hard to find the details. But basically in this world, no one believes in monsters. Everything is perfect. It's a utopia. I believe our main character is also transgender. I'm just excited to see what it is. It's a super short one, but as Cody said, it's very impactful, so I'm excited about that. It has nearly 7,000 ratings, and the ratings are actually 4.20, the average, which is very high, so, you know, good to know. Then I have an adult mystery thriller. It's a book that even my mom read when I was still living at home, which is eons ago now. It has taken me so long to pick this up, but it's The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. I know there's a movie, thankfully I haven't seen it, so I have not spoiled myself for this, and also another checker, but this is all about this disappearance that took place 40 years ago, and now this man is the uncle of the girl that disappeared, is trying to find more information about it and hires these two investigators, and I think one of them is the girl with the tattoos. So this actually has 2.5 million reviews, so that's nice, and the average is 4.14, which is, I don't think I've ever seen that in my life, like, to have such a high rating from so many ratings is crazy. I mean, I haven't looked at Game of Thrones, though, to be honest, so maybe that, but... another book that I have, ooh, floppy, very, very floppy, is No True Believers. So this is a YA thriller, and it promises a girl, it promises themes of conspiracies, fighting Islamophobia, especially after a recent terrorist attack in the book, and also promises a realistic depiction of chronic illness, so I'm just overall very piqued in interest. And the main character is, I think, a coder, which is, you know, really cool. So this only has 127 reviews, and the rating is 3.95. So I'm intrigued. I'll come back to you again. So the next one is an odd one, I think. It's called On Luna Time. This is a book about a girl who lives in foster care and gets, like, kind of sent from home to home. And on her 18th birthday, she finds a letter from her mother, and she really wants to find out who are her true family or biological family. In the letter, from the synopsis, in the letter, she is told by her mother to jump off a cliff, and she does it. But instead of, I'm assuming, dying, she time travels. So already I'm just like, this sounds, are you alright? But at the same time, I'm kind of here for it. And this is a romance novel as well, somehow. This is an adult romance novel. I think that's like a historical fiction adult romance. Sorry. So she travels 17 years back, I think, and I don't really know much else about it, but this is a book that Murphy has spoken about in one of her videos and recommended as a romance. So my intrigue is, I just find it so ridiculous that she jumped, so I'm already really questioning the main character, but also it includes time travel, which is one of the tastiest things for me, so I'm very excited to read this. I got this in the Kindle version. Just excited. And the next one, I'm gonna go for an audiobook, I think, or maybe mix with a Kindle. And that is The Rage of Dragons, which is most recent purchase. I wanted to originally skip this one because I was thinking of reading it in August, but then I was like, I have way too many books, and I'm thinking this is also a big one, and it's an epic fantasy, and it's, you know, it takes a while to read. And I thought, like, oh, I'll come to it at some point else. But then I was talking to Murphy, and Murphy literally shouted her excitement about this series. So I was like, well, you leave me no choice. And I went and got the Kindle, but then she said that it's a very good audiobook, so I'm probably gonna listen to that. I'm very excited. Apparently it focuses a lot on, it's an African inspired one, and apparently it focuses a lot on, like, a warrior bond. I'm not entirely sure, but from the synopsis it seems like it focuses on, it says, many people only know war, and some people are born with kind of like a hulky, you know, they can hulk out and be like strong warriors, and then some can't, and our main character cannot, and he does not want to spend his life fighting a war. He has a secret plan of getting injured and then, like, you know, escaping and having a family and settling down, but his family gets unfortunately murdered, and now he is driven by revenge, and all he wants is to become the best swordsman. So I'm tentatively excited because I know Murphy mentioned that it basically is a lot of fight scenes, which is usually my least favorite part of books, so tentatively excited, but there's a lot of training rather than like fighting, and training I can do, so we'll see. It has 11,000 reviews and the rating is extremely high, it's 4.38 as well, so I'm very excited tentatively because of the fight thing. But that is it, we have made it. I hope you guys enjoyed it though. Let me know if you're gonna pick up any of these books. I obviously cannot recommend or not recommend these books, none of them. I read Chloe Brown one, this one, but all the rest of them I have not read yet, so obviously this is just what I think they're about. Let me know if you read any of these and really liked it or disliked it, just let me know your thoughts. Thank you so much for watching, I'll see you in the next one. Stay awesome. Oh my god, it literally cut off when I was saying bye. Goodbye.